If you're learning to code right now because you heard developers make $200,000 a year, I have bad news. That era is over. The golden age of high-paying dev jobs just ended and most people haven't noticed yet. But the data doesn't lie, and if you're not paying attention, you're going to waste years chasing a dream that already died. First, let's talk about what actually happened. In 2021 and 2022, tech companies were hiring like crazy. Software engineers were getting $150,000 starting salaries. New grads with one internship were getting multiple offers. Developers were job hopping every year for 30% raises. It felt like it would last forever, but it didn't. In 2022 and 2023, over 400,000 tech workers got laid off. Google, Meta, Amazon, Microsoft, they all cut tens of thousands of jobs. And here's what nobody tells you. Those jobs aren't coming back. Companies realized they overhired. They realized they could do more with fewer people. And now they're not just being careful about hiring, they're actively trying to reduce headcount. Meta laid off over 21,000 employees, Amazon cut 27,000 jobs, Google eliminated 12,000 positions. These aren't startups running out of money. These are profitable companies making record revenues. They're laying people off because they can, because the market changed. And the developers who got cut, most of them are still looking for jobs a year later. Second, the competition exploded while the opportunities disappeared. In 2019, if you had a CS degree and could code, you were basically guaranteed a job. Companies were desperate. But now, everyone learned to code during the pandemic. Bootcamps pumped out thousands of graduates. Online courses made coding accessible to millions. And all those people are competing for fewer jobs than ever before. New grad positions that used to get 50 applications now get 5,000. Entry-level jobs require 3 years of experience. Internships are more competitive than full-time roles used to be. And it's not just more developers, it's global competition. Companies realized during the pandemic that remote work actually works, so now they're hiring developers in countries where the salary expectations are a fraction of what US developers want. Why pay someone $150,000 in San Francisco when you can hire someone just as good in Eastern Europe or Latin America for $50,000? The arbitrage is too obvious. Companies are taking advantage of it, and US developers are losing. And third, AI is already replacing entry-level work, not in some distant future, right now. Junior developers used to spend their time writing boilerplate code, fixing bugs, writing tests, basic implementation work, but that's exactly what AI tools are good at. GitHub Copilot, ChatGPT, Cursor, they can generate that code instantly. So companies don't need as many junior developers anymore. One senior developer with AI tools can do the work that used to require a team of three juniors. And here's the brutal part. The skills that juniors used to learn on the job, the basic coding and debugging, that's exactly what AI is eliminating. So new developers aren't getting the experience they need to become senior developers. The ladder is breaking. Companies want senior developers who can architect systems and make high-level decisions. They don't want to train juniors when AI can handle the junior work. So what does this mean? The average developer salary is stagnant or declining. The days of job hopping for 30% raises every year are over. Developers are taking pay cuts just to stay employed. And the new grads entering the market, many of them aren't finding jobs at all. The ones who do are accepting salaries that would have been considered low 5 years ago. This isn't temporary. This is the new normal. The market corrected. The gold rush ended. And everyone who rushed in thinking they'd get rich as a developer is realizing they're late to the party. That gold rush is done. Learn to code if you actually love building things and solving problems, because that's the only reason that's going to sustain you through this new market. Your professional identity is scattered everywhere. LinkedIn, GitHub, Google Scholar, personal sites. It's exhausting to maintain and impossible to keep updated. That's where DinkCard comes in. It's a living, AI-powered identity that pulls everything together automatically. Upload your resume once, and Dink builds a clean, customizable page that updates in real time. New project? It's there. New publication? Already added. Dink's Discover feature lets you search for talent, build networks, and find collaborations in one place. Recruiters can verify your skills instantly. Your cold outreach gets taken seriously because your profile proves credibility. No more static PDFs. Dink Card is your professional identity for the AI era. Check it out with the code SHADE. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.